when it comes to the Prophet Muhammad, no. Everything you have a must take. Udkhulu fi silmi kaffa. The third thing he said, rahimahullah. قال ابن وهب سمعت مالكا سئل عن تخليل عن تخليل اصابع الرجلين في الوضوء فقال ليس ذلك على الناس قال فتركته حتى خف الناس فقلت له عندنا في ذلك سنه فقال وما هي قلت حدثنا الليث بن سعد وابن لهيه وعمر بن الحارث أن يزيد عن عمر عن عمرو المعافري عن أبي عبد الرحمن الحبلي عن المستورد ابن شداد القرشي قال رأيت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يدلك بخنصره ما بين أصابع رجليه. Wahab, this Wahab, he is one of the leading students of Imam Malik. He said, "Sami'tu Malikan su'ila an takhlil al-asabi." Wahab said, "I heard Imam Malik being asked about cleaning between the toes. If you make wudu, to clean between your toes." Faqala Malik, faqala laysa dhalika 'ala an-nas. So Imam Malik said, it is not important on people to do that. So look at the student. He said, fataraktuhu hatta khaffa an-nas. He said, I left him until everybody left. He said, and I came to him, faqultu lahu innana fi dhalika sunnah. We know of sunnah about that. When it comes to us, in our place where I came from, it is sunnah. He said, where did you get this from? And he narrated the chain of the hadith to Imam Malik. When he finished narrating that the hadith is Shaddad al-Qurashi, he said, Ibn Shaddad al-Qurashi, he said, that's Mustawri. Or Mustawrat. Mustawrat. He said, Inna hadha al-hadith hasan. He said, Ra'aytu Rasulallah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam yadluku bikhinsarihi ma bayna asabihi rijlay. He said, I saw the Prophet, al-khinsar is the middle finger. So he said, he saw, Imam Malik heard that, and he heard the chain of the hadith. He said, yes, this hadith is Hassan. Listen to Imam Malik. Wahab said, وَمَا سَمِيتُ بِهِ قَتْ إِلَّا السَّاعَ. Imam Malik said, I never heard this hadith until today. So, you may ask, okay, why do they even give any verdict which contradicts Quran and Sunnah sometimes? Sometimes maybe the hadith did not get to them. But they are scholars. Allah bless them with knowledge. So they will give opinion. But when something authentic comes to them and it contradicts what they say, they will then leave their opinion. Because Imam Malik said, I never heard this hadith before. Until now. ثُمَّ سَمِيتُ بَعْدَ ذَلِكَ يُسْأَلْ فَيَأْمُرُ بِتَخْلِيلِ الْأَصَابِعِ. May Allah bless Imam Malik. Wahab said, I heard him being asked about the same thing. The question they asked him before, he said no. Now, after I narrated this hadith to him, whenever they ask him, he will say, yes, it is sunnah that you should what? Clean in between your toes. With your khinsar. You see, the finger that the Prophet used to clean the toe, the Sahaba gave it to us. You can say, does it matter? Any finger you can clean with it but they're teaching us which finger the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam cleaned the toe with. Now, so we go. What's next? Al-Shafi'i. Good. Al-Shafi'i rahimahullah. Wa qala Imam Al-Shafi'i rahimahullah. Sheikh said, "Falnaqul anhu fi dhalika akthar wa atyab." First thing he said, Sheikh said, Imam Al-Shafi'i said, "Ma min ahadin illa wa tadhhabu alayhi sunnatun li rasulillahi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wa ta'zubu anhu. Famahma qulta min qawlin aw asalta min aslin fihi ar-rasulillahi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam khilafa ma qultu falqawlu ma qala rasulillahi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wa huwa qawli." Imam Shafi said, "Ma min ahadin." The sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam reach as well as escape everyone. Nobody can tell you he heard all the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Nobody can tell you that. Nobody can tell you he knows all the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You know some. You know some. The rest, leave it to Allah. So he's saying, فَمَهْمَا قُلْتُ مِنْ قَوْلٍ فَمَهْمَا قُلْتُ مِنْ قَوْلٍ. So whatever I voice my opinion on, أَوْ أَصَّلْتُ مِنْ أَصْلٍ فِيهِ الرَّسُولِ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ, or he formulates a principle. You know, sometimes they will give answer to a question that they don't have a proof in the Quran and the hadith, but they will look some other hadith and occasion what happened, so they will try to take out, you know, answer from it. It is not directly for that, but maybe some situation, it will make them, because Allah bless them with the knowledge, they will try to pull those proofs from some other hadith that is not direct to the, which is not direct to the answer given to them, and they will give. But they will tell you later on, if you find something which contradicts what I say and is authentic, then you should leave what I say and follow what the authentic hadith said. He said, فَالْقَوْلُ مَا قَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ وَهُوَ قَوْلِي. The correct view, the correct saying, is what the Messenger of Allah said. Is what the Messenger of Allah has said, and it is my view. Brothers, are we following this? He said, correct saying is what the Prophet said, and what the Prophet said is what he said. That's it. The second thing he said, أَجْمَعَ الْمُسْلِمُونَ عَلَىٰ أَنَّ من استبان له سنة عن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم لم يحل له أن يدعها لقول أحد. This is very serious. Sheikh said, the Muslims, the scholars, the Muslims have come together and they said, listen to what they said. They all agreed that if a sunnah of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم is made clear for someone, then it is not permitted for the person to leave it. If something is made clear to you from today that the Prophet said, then you can never leave it. You shall not leave it. Now, we continue. He said, the third thing, إذا وجدتم في كتابي خلاف سنة رسول الله فقولوا بسنة رسول الله. اللهم صل على محمد. Imam Shafi'i said, if you did, you find in my writings something different to the sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad, Fakulu bi sunnati Rasulillah. Then speak on the basis of the sunnah of the Prophet. Wada'u ma kultu. La ilaha illallah. He said, leave what I said, please. I wrote it down. I said it. I wrote it down. If you find it different to what the Prophet said, please leave what I said. Wa fi riwayatin fattabi'uha wa la taltafitu ila qawli ahadin. He said, another narration, he said, follow it. Follow the sunnah of the Prophet and do not look sideways. Do not look anything at anyone else saying. If the Prophet says something, don't wait and hear anybody else. That's it. If Muhammad said it, it's final. Just follow it. That's it. This is the only way you will be what? Because he is the only personality who should be followed in everything. Muhammad Rasulullah. If we keep going, you want us to continue the talking, saying of the A'imma? We continue the saying of the A'imma? Okay. The fifth, the fourth, right? إِذَا صَحَّ الْحَدِيثُ فَهُوَ مَذْهَبِي. When hadith is found to be sahih, that is my madhab. If you remember, who said it first? This same talk. Who said it first? Imam Abu Hanifa. Same thing, right? إِذَا صَحَّ الْحَدِيثُ فَهُوَ مَذْهَبِي. If hadith is found to be sahih, to be authentic, this is my madhab. The 15, he said, أنتم أعلم بالحديث والرجال مني فإذا كان الحديث الصحيح فأعلموني به أي شيء يكون كوفيا أو بصريا أو شاميا حتى أذهب إليه إذا كان صحيحا. He said, you are more knowledgeable about the hadith than I. He is talking to Imam Ahmad, his student. You know, Imam Ahmad learned from Imam Abu Hanifa. And Imam Abu Hanifa learned from Imam Malik. Imam Ahmad, he learned from, no, Imam Ahmad learned from Imam Shafi'i. And Imam Shafi'i learned from Imam Malik. Imam Ahmad learned from Imam Shafi'i. And Imam Shafi'i learned from Imam Malik. Yeah. So he said to Imam Ahmad, Antum a'lamu bil hadithi wal rijali minni. You are more knowledgeable. He's telling his student. A teacher telling his student, you are more knowledgeable about hadith than I. So, فَإِذَا كَانَ الْحَدِيثُ الصَّحِيحُ. So when hadith is a sahih, فَأَعْلِمُونِ. Inform me, tell me. If hadith is authentic, Imam Ahmad, you are my student, but you are more knowledgeable about hadith than me. If hadith is found to be authentic, please inform me. It doesn't matter. He said, أَيُّ شَيْءٍ يَكُونَ. It doesn't matter where the hadith is coming from. Kufiyan is from Kufa. Where is Kufa? Kufa. Kufa. No, Kufa. The state, the city Kufa is from Iraq. You know why? That time, they have a lot of what? Scholars. Kufa is an historic city. Baghdad. Kufa is an historic city. So, maybe the hadith was narrated by the scholars of Kufa. He said it doesn't matter where it comes from. If it's authentic, Kufiyan. If it's from Kufa, what's next? Aw Basariyan, or it's from Basra. Basra is also from where? Iraq. Aw Shamiyan. Where is Sham? Syria. Brothers, these three countries, they had a lot of great scholars. Great. Imam al-Ghazali, all of them. Yeah.